in wrestling history, and certainly one of the biggest stars of Hollywood, splitting time between in the ring and on the silver screen. Hopefully, we look forward to seeing the return of Rowdy Piper to WCW Monday Nitro very, very soon, Mike, today.
Well, there was a lot of talk this past weekend in Las Vegas where tickets went on sale for the upcoming Halloween Havoc event about Rowdy Piper, and we can't wait until he gets back to the WCW ring.
Well, that's where he made his return at Halloween Havoc a year ago at the MGM Grand. And when Halloween Havoc returns, we hope that you will be with us as well at the MGM Grand this coming October. We go back to action here live on WCW Monday Nitro, as we're going to see a match involving, I was going to say, the Luchadors one-on-one, but we have not only Villano IV, but Villano V coming out here, Mike.
Well, the two brothers, sons of the legendary Rey Mendoza from Mexico, Villano IV and V come out to match up with Lizmark. And seeing these two Luchadors reminds me that Rey Mysterio Jr. paid a visit this past week to Dr. James Andrews, the noted sports surgeon, and we can tell you that Rey will not require surgery on injured knee.
That's good.
Rehab work upcoming in the swimming pool and the weight room, and he will return with a knee brace, possibly within the next month.
Well, that's great news.
Well, it could be good. You know, so many guys make the mistake of coming back too early. Always let the injury repair itself 100%. You say knee brace, I don't like to hear that. That tells me it's not 100%.
Lizmark and Villano IV to go one-on-one here on WCW Monday Nitro, this three-hour special edition on the second anniversary of the debut of our program on this Labor Day 1997. This time Villano looked like he wanted to send him on the outside, but Lizmark, great balance. He was so agile. Drag takedown.
Two second-generation competitors. Their fathers had many memorable matches in Mexico. Kind of an interesting clash of styles here with the high-flying Lizmark, tilt-a-whirl backbreaker, and Villano IV, more of a mat technician.
And a drop kick, perfectly executed that time. Villano IV on the outside. Here we go. How about that one? Over the top suicide dive. At first, it was Villano IV that took all of that.
Well, Lizmark Jr. and his father from Acapulco, they're cliff divers there, so their high-flying moves come naturally.
How about that? On the inside now. Underneath the bottom rope, both men back in. Lizmark runs right into a running lariat.
Hey, Lizmark is wobbly. Here's a guy that took the high risk, but I think he hurt himself more.
Pick up. Ernest Carey slam. They're looking at Raven. Look at Raven walk in the aisleway there. Where is he going?
Where is he coming from?
I don't know. You never know about Raven. One of the most mysterious competitors we have ever seen. And we call him competitor only because he has been in only one match. And that was at the Clash of the Champions under his terms. I don't know if he's walking to the ring or where he's going, but he certainly is here. And we're going to follow this to find out exactly what he's up to here tonight live on WCW Monday Nitro. Meanwhile in the ring, Villano IV with back elbow, and Lizmark Jr. crashes to the mat again.
Now, we have seen the Villanos on many occasions recently use a switch where the other brother will come into the ring, allowing them to gain victories in tag team matches as well as in singles bouts.
I hear an Andalay. What does that mean?
Into the ropes. Ducking low. Spin wheel kick caught the man, brought him down. Lizmark with a cover. He got a two, and that was all. Up on top again. One, two. The Huracarana got him down, but only got a two count that time.
Yeah, Lizmark's making nice moves, but he's a little weak on finishing off his opponents. We should have had him hooked twice. And
this time just kicked him off. Feet met feet that time, and Lizmark goes to the mat.
What's that guy saying in the corner? You were in Mexico. What's it mean?
Well, he's trying to get his brother fired up. That's what he's doing, cheering him on.
Oh,
how about that?
Not working.
Basically gave him a hip toss or a Beal maneuver over the top rope to the floor. But the match will continue.
Lizmark,
cross body block from the top.
You guys are insane. Look at that steel stiff. He missed it by inches.
Well, that high-risk plancha is one of the moves that his father, Lizmark, invented, one of the pioneers of high-flying wrestling.
It's Lizmark back in. And now the first man in is Villano.
They just made the switch. That's Villano 5, the fresh man that just came in.
You're right. You can see it on his trunks. It is Villano 5.
Check the Roman numerals.
You're right. You can see that now as Villano 4 stood down there. But Lizmark took a world slam, got the man down. Ducks low, hits the middle rope. Moonsault 1, 2, 3, and he beats Villano 5.
How about that? It backfired on him that time.
And now they're trying to tell the referee, wait a minute, wrong man. Well, that's their fault.
Well, actually, it doesn't count because he pinned an illegal man.
Is the referee calling for the bell? Is the referee saying restart the match? He missed that drop kick. But he's saying that Lizmark got the win.
I can't keep up with the luchador rules.
The only thing we know is that Lizmark comes away with a win. It may have been the wrong guy, but it was still a win for Lizmark Jr. As you look at this capacity crowd on hand.
You know what? They're all waiting to hear what Hollywood Hulk Hogan has to say.
Here it is again there, legend.
Well, watch this. This guy takes some high-risk maneuvers. Hurt himself. He was lucky. He almost hit those steel steps. And right there, Villano, whichever one that is, holding his head. But I think they did make the switch right here. The one holding his hand down. Look at him. He pops right in. Lizmark saw him coming, though. And he still came right over and got the pinfall. Enough luchadors. I want to hear what Hogan has to say about J.J. Dillon.